Welcome back. In this series of videos, we are learning how to make our Microsoft Word documents accessible for all students, including students with visual impairments. As a reminder, oftentimes there may be a program that is reading or interpreting the text to the student, so we need to be sure that our format, our code, our layout is in a format that the program can read. We're going to be looking at headers today, making sure that our headers are coded correctly. So as you can see here, we have a sample heading, and it's not enough to just make the font bigger, make it bold, underlined, maybe we'll change the color. That's not going to be significant to indicate that that's a heading, because if you come up here, we're on the Home tab, make sure you're on the Home tab, and we have our different styles. This text is normal. So if a computer or a program is reading this, it will not recognize this as a header. So what you need to do is you need to select the text that you would like to make a header, and you're going to select one of these options. Heading 1, heading 2, heading 3, 4, 5, and then a title. I'm going to select this as heading 2. We'll talk a little bit more about color later, but a blue might be hard to read. After you have it selected as a heading 2, you can go ahead and make all of your changes, make it bold, make it big, and you can make all those changes and it's still listed as a heading 2. So now it is in the correct format. The headings work in a hierarchy. Heading 1 is like the title of a book, and you should only have one heading per page. Heading 2 are like chapter titles, and heading 3 are like the subsections on those chapters. And it works very similar to a timeline. Sorry, not a timeline, an outline. So if you think about PowerPoint and having those points and subpoints, you can use headings in a similar fashion. Let me show you an example. So here is a really simple outline of how to make a cake. It is not finished, but you can see I've got heading 1, heading 2, and then both of these are heading 3. In a way that might visually make a lot of sense to see how these are broken down, if you come up here to View, come here to Show, click on a navigational panel, and now you can see your headings, and you can see that they are broken out into their different sections. So heading 1, heading 2, heading 3, and heading 3. It is very important that you do not skip the order of any of the headings. So if you're having a heading 1, a heading 2, don't skip to a heading 4. The next one should be a heading 3. This picture here can also help you to visualize how the heading hierarchy works. Oh, make sure that whenever you have a title, make sure that you come up here, make sure you're in Home, Styles, and select the style that you need for your headings.